that you meet, and we've got to change that.
But everyone involved with the club knows that won't be easy. Howard Wilkinson has repaired the team, but the image the club has is another matter. It's one of football's facts of life that Leeds United are one of the most unpopular clubs in Britain, no matter what they do. The bad publicity a section of Leeds fans have attracted over the years is one reason. All Leeds fans, young and old, are saddled with the same reputation. Another reason is rooted in the fact that between 1964 and 74, Leeds were top of the pile. Their relentless style won them many matches, but fewer friends. But they were good. So good at times they were able to toy with people.
Oh, look at that! It's almost cruel.
Fair to say that in the popularity stakes and for singing, for Leeds United it was nil point. No doubting they were a great footballing side though. In those days, Leeds really were top men. A dossier on the club under Don Revie shows great consistency. In Leeds, the Revie era is known as the glory years. After Revie, a string of managers came and went. Brian Clough, Jimmy Armfield and others. But for one reason or another, it never quite worked out. Heroes from the glory years were brought back to rekindle a fire Revie had lit. But it didn't happen.
You've got the wrong idea, so...
So much so, when Howard Wilkinson arrived, he was the club's eighth manager in 15 years. There were more pressing problems than popularity to consider. Leeds were staring Division 3 right in the face. But now, under Wilkinson, Leeds, last season's second division champions, stand fourth in Division 1. They've reached the semi-final of the Rumbelows Cup, and past glories aren't to become a millstone.
Is the story I hear that one day you went around and took down from the wall a lot of the old pictures, is that accurate?
Yeah, it's accurate. I mean, it was not a sign of disrespect, but I did feel that we had to remove history, as it were, from our immediate environment and try and replace it with our own history.
On the pitch, so far, so good. The question is whether things are going as well off the pitch. Over the last 20 years, Leeds fans at home and abroad have been involved in many serious incidents of crowd trouble. It was Leeds fans who rioted in Bournemouth last year. So what are the club doing about it? No one pretends the problem's gone away. Bournemouth proved that. Leeds would rather talk about the steps they've taken to make sure it doesn't happen again. A computerised membership scheme with over 30,000 clients is designed to make sure that only people Leeds want to have tickets actually get tickets for Sunday's cup tie at Highbury.
You are my contacts with the sort of 270-odd stewards that are here.
In close liaison with the police, Leeds stewarding aims to take the heat out of any situation that could precipitate crowd trouble. Leeds employ a private security company who work alongside the club's own stewards, some of whom travel with Leeds' massive away support, the idea to change the attitude of potential troublemakers.
But it's long been the policy here that if people are being a nuisance, we give them every opportunity to amend their conduct before we consider arrest.
West Yorkshire Police are happy that communication and a policy of firm yet sensitive policing is the right tactic. But Elland Road is their patch. The real test is when Leeds go on the road. Around the country, so far, the reaction has been good. A good report from Merseyside. And also the West Midlands. The Manchester United game went well. There was an incident at Main Road, but the FA found Leeds had no case to answer. West Yorkshire Police are happy with the situation so far.
The majority of football fans are law-abiding. The vast majority. It's the minority who cause the problems. What we've got to do is to police the majority as we would like to be policed, and then deal with the minority in isolation.
And are you finding that the majority are now starting to police the minority?
Yes, they are. What's happening now at Elland Road is I've never seen, certainly this season towards the end of last, so many women and children. And if you look at women and children integrated within any part of the stadium, then that has got to be a self-policing initiative.
The move towards self-policing has played a major part in Leeds' efforts to improve their image. The fanzine culture has helped too. A group of fans publish Marching All Together, dedicated to ridding the terraces of racism.
By the mid-1980s, Leeds had really reached a very low point in terms of the behaviour of the crowd. There was a very violent atmosphere at Ellen Road, and there was a very racist atmosphere at Ellen Road. It was really, I have to say, as a Leeds fan, it was a very unpleasant place to watch football. People were just behaving very badly, and we felt as a group of Leeds fans that we could no longer tolerate that behaviour.
We've been part of a general thing that has given a voice back to the ordinary fans down there. They've got, ordinary people have got the confidence to say, you know, we don't boo black players because, you know, because we're decent people.
There's no longer that hard man image that is, you know, the thing to aspire to. I think people now feel that, you know, particularly with the good black players we've got playing for Leeds now, that they want to support them.